Okay, quick question. When is winter? December, right? And Christmas? Snow? Cold weather? Hot chocolate? Well, not everywhere. In the Southern Hemisphere, December is beach season. Santa wears sunglasses. And winter? That's in July. Strange? Maybe. But this is just one of the many things that make the Southern Hemisphere completely different from the rest of the world. We always talk about the Northern Hemisphere because, well, most people live there. But what about the other half of the planet? The one with fewer people, more ocean, insane landscapes, and record-breaking extremes. Welcome to the Southern Hemisphere, where storms spin backwards, deserts never get rain, and the night sky isn't the one you're used to seeing. Let's start with something surprising. The Southern Hemisphere has way fewer people than you think. Now, you might think the world is pretty evenly split between North and South, but get this, only about 12% of the world's population lives in the Southern Hemisphere. Yup, that means nearly 9 out of 10 people live up north. The rest? Spread out below the equator, across some of the most extreme and remote places on Earth. You've got fewer people, fewer megacities, and way more space to stretch your legs. Unless you're in Australia, where everything's trying to bite you. So why is it so empty? Well, part of it has to do with what comes next. Less land, more water. All right, now let's talk real estate. If you thought the Southern Hemisphere just felt emptier, you're absolutely right, because it's mostly water. Over 80% of the Southern Hemisphere is covered by oceans. That's like trying to find your socks in a giant swimming pool. Meanwhile, the Northern Hemisphere is much more balanced. More land, more people, and a lot more cities stuck in traffic. This watery world has some side effects too, like fewer factories and highways, which means cleaner air, darker skies, and way better views of the stars. That brings us to one of the Southern Hemisphere's best-kept secrets, and possibly the coolest thing you've never looked up at. When night falls in the Southern Hemisphere, it doesn't just get dark, it gets spectacular. Thanks to fewer big cities, way less artificial light, and all that ocean, the southern skies are some of the cleanest on Earth. And what do you get with clean skies? A front row seat to the Southern Cross, the Magellanic Clouds, and galaxies you can't even see from up north. Astronomers and stargazers love the Southern Hemisphere. Honestly, if the night sky were a concert, this would be VIP seating with no one tall in front of you. But it's not just the stars that behave differently down here. Even the storms have their own southern style. While cyclones in the Northern Hemisphere spin counterclockwise, down here, thanks to something called the Coriolis effect, they twirl clockwise like they're dancing to their own beat. And yes, you may have heard that toilets flush in the opposite direction too. Technically true, but only if your bathroom is the size of a small country. But cyclones? Those are the real deal. The Southern Hemisphere is home to some seriously powerful storms. And speaking of power, did you know the ground beneath your feet down here is way more restless than you might think? The Southern Hemisphere isn't just chill beaches and cute penguins. It's also sitting on a ticking geological dance floor. This part of the world is part of the Pacific Ring of Fire, which means earthquakes, volcanoes, and tectonic tension are all in the mix, from Indonesia to New Zealand to Chile. If Earth had a stress ball, this region would be the part it keeps squeezing. And speaking of stress and pressure, there's one massive result of all this tectonic drama. Let's talk about the Andes, the longest continental mountain range on the planet. Stretching over 7,000 kilometers down the western edge of South America, the Andes Mountains are basically Earth's spine, only way cooler and covered in llamas. They cross 7 countries: Argentina, Bolivia, Chile, Colombia, Ecuador, Peru, and Venezuela. They shape the weather, block clouds, and give rise to ancient civilizations like the Inca. But move just a little to the west or south, and that moisture-blocking magic creates something else entirely. Welcome to the dry side of paradise, where you'll find some of the most extreme deserts on Earth. If you think deserts are all the same, just hot, sandy, and full of camels, the Southern Hemisphere is here to challenge your entire mental image. Start with the Atacama Desert in Chile, the driest non-polar desert on Earth. Some parts haven't seen rain in centuries. It's not just desert, dry. That's forgot your phone charger on vacation dry. Then swing over to Africa for the Namib, possibly the oldest desert on Earth, with sand dunes dating back over 50 million years. Basically, a fossilized beach with attitude. Right next door, the Kalahari Desert offers a twist. It's semi-arid, dotted with life, and home to meerkats with better social lives than most of us. But hold on, what about Australia? Yep, it's got deserts, too. Lots of them. In fact, around 70% of the continent is arid or semi-arid. With names like the Great Victoria, Simpson, and Great Sandy, they sound more like adventure parks than barren wastelands. But don't be fooled. They're big, bold, and absolutely boiling. From some of the driest, dustiest spots on Earth, let's flip the script. Ready to dive into some of the greenest, wildest jungles on the planet? Next stop, nature's air conditioner. From bone-dry deserts to rain-drenched jungles, the Southern Hemisphere doesn't do subtle. Let's start with the Amazon rainforest, the largest tropical rainforest in the world, pumping out oxygen like nature's own air purifier. It's home to 1 in 10 known species on Earth. That's right. If you name 10 animals, chances are one of them lives here, possibly judging you from a tree branch right now. Then there's the Congo rainforest in Africa's south, and the New Guinea rainforest, the largest in the Asia Pacific, packed with species you won't find anywhere else, including birds of paradise that look like they were designed by a child with a glitter pen. These green giants are biodiversity hotspots and climate stabilizers. And in the Southern Hemisphere, they stretch far and wide, buzzing, chirping, and photosynthesizing, while the rest of the world forgets they're even there. But enough greenery, ready for a landscape that looks like you've stepped onto another planet? Welcome to Salar de Uyuni in Bolivia, the world's largest salt flat, and possibly the world's most surreal selfie backdrop. This place is so flat, I mean, flatter than a pancake on a yoga mat, that NASA literally uses it to calibrate satellites. Yup, space tech trusts this salty floor more than a ruler. But Salar isn't just high tech. After it rains, it transforms into a massive natural mirror, reflecting the clouds, stars, and your questionable hiking hat. And speaking of high places with water, our next stop floats higher than any ship should logically go. Welcome to Lake Titicaca. And yes, that's its real name. Sitting at 3,812 meters above sea level, that's over 12,500 feet. It's the highest navigable lake in the world. Boats actually sail up here, carrying people, potatoes, and probably ponchos, all in thin Andean air. If you've ever felt out of breath walking upstairs, try paddling a canoe here. And nestled near this high-altitude marvel is something equally rare. A capital city in the Americas that's entirely south of the equator, and closest to it than any other capital on Earth. Many countries in the Southern Hemisphere have their capitals well below the equator, from Jakarta to Canberra, and from Brasilia to Pretoria. but only one capital city on Earth sits almost right on the equator, and that's Quito, the proud highland capital of Ecuador, a country that literally means equator. Yep, they didn't beat around the bush when naming it. Quito lies just 25 kilometers south of latitude zero, and you can actually visit the spot where the northern and southern hemispheres shake hands. And if that's not cool enough, Quito also reaches a sky-high 2,850 meters above sea level. So not only are you near the middle of the world, you're also closer to the stars. At the crossroads of hemispheres and heights, Quito is a capital that really knows how to make a point. 0 degrees, to be exact. So, next time someone says, the world, remember, half of it lies quietly below the equator, with its own wonders, extremes, and sky patterns spinning in reverse. It may have fewer people, but it's packed with personality. The Southern Hemisphere isn't just the other half, it's the better half. At least when it comes to stargazing, surfing, and satellite calibrating salt flats. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this journey to the other side of the world, give it a like, share it with a fellow geography nerd. And don't forget to subscribe for more mind-bending maps and unexpected facts. Until next time, stay curious wherever you are on this beautiful blue planet.